MMA fighting here with Andy Ryan, head of Bellator Dublin. Andy, first of all, some big absentees there on the card now without Redzer on it. I mean, how much of a blow is it that Redzer won't be on this card? Because I see lots of the fans really upset that he won't be competing that night.
Yeah, I think for the Dublin fans, they love Redzer. Redzer's a sort of household name. He's the champion that hasn't been the champion in the three arena yet. You know, he seems to pull in the crowd. He's the guy that the people fight for to get the main event slots. He's got the big break. Bellator would give him the big fight, and then we break his leg.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I was just saying to Paul. Like, I mean, two big names now, and unfortunately, two injuries. Do you believe that it won't be a case where he has to kind of rebuild up to this situation again when he comes back? Do you feel he will get one of those big names from the US?
Yeah, like even now, he's on the crutches and his legs in the cast. He's in the gym training, so he's not doing nothing. I think our goal is to look say to Bellator. You know, he's going to be ready January, February. Let's put him on in the States. He's no spring chicken anymore. They've done all their visa stuff and got all their passport stuff with him, so he wants him in America. So let's throw him over there and let him. I think one or two fights he's in contention for a title there, you know. And he's still young enough.
Absolutely. Now, a lot of people, when Paul came away from the fight, they were hoping that Myles Price, who was a bit of an omission from this card because of the fight with Queedy last time around, how much interest that was. Was there any talk of that at all, that Myles could maybe jump in to take his place?
Yeah, Myles asked for it, but I'll be honest with you, Myles had gone through, torn down a couple of opponents. I don't think his head was in the right place. He was just training in America. He was training with guys fighting on big shows, and I don't think he was minding it was on Dublin. He offered, got a couple of offers, he turned them down. He's actually fighting later in the year with Bellator. He jumped in there straight away. The second he heard Redzo was injured, he said, I'm over in America, I'm training, I'm fit. I'll stay here if they give me the fight. And just Bellator, he had someone else lined up. I think, I didn't want to be disrespectful to Myles, I think, but it's Redzo has built his name over every show, UFC, Bama, Bellator, KSW. So he's a big name. And to replace him, it's another big name, an ex-UFC guy. So I think it's the right guy who's replacing him. But Myles was ready there to do it. And I think Myles would have given him a good fight. I think Myles would have been, especially training in AKA, he was in a good, he came back fit anyway, you know.
Obviously, there's still a huge domestic fight on the card for Team Ryano with Phil Mulpeter and Keith McCabe. I mean, does this take on even more importance? Like we've had a lot of drop-offs this card. Do you believe this card, that fight in particular, is becoming way more significant for this card?
Yeah, we had this before. Reza before, another fight's fallen off and Reza sort of stepping up, and I think this time for Keith is very quiet. Keith doesn't roar and shout. Keith is very, very good, very talented fighter. Philip McPeter is one of Ireland's legends in MMA, you know, he's a lovely guy. Can't say anything bad about him. He actually coached the Irish team with me in the European Championships, and we spoke before the fight was announced. I say, look, two guys are athletes, it's a fight, no hard feelings, shake hands before and after the fight. And I'm actually looking forward to it. I think it could be the fight of the night. You got two experienced guys. Like Keith's a jiu-jitsu black belt. Phil McPeter's fought everywhere all over the world. He's tough as nails. And I think for me, looking on the card as an experienced coach and, you know, travel the world, and I look and say, there's two fighters I want to see fight. You know, some of the other ones you look and say, yeah, they are tough fights. But for me, that's when I say, yeah, and I can agree with you. It should take the line right now. And it's good that yous are here today for us, you know, giving us a bit of publicity. So the likes of this people know more about this fight, you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, it is a big one for Keith, right? Because Phil is one of those names. You're not going to find many people that don't respect Phil. Everybody loves the guy. He was one of those guys that everyone thought would end up in the UFC. Is this a big opponent for Keith, do you, Phil?
Huge opponent. He was very unlucky not to hit the UFC. He was one of them guys with Cottle and Chris and them guys that were trying hard, that SBG bunch that was like he beat John Donnelly out there, Jim. John Donnelly's a killer, you know. He's had good fights with Redzer and stuff, and, you know, I think, yeah, I was very, very lucky not to see him in the UFC. And then he didn't get that run with Bama when he came here, and I think he retired and he came back and he had a good run with Cage Warriors. But I think, yeah, it's a tough fight. Is he going to be too old? I don't know, because someone like Philip and Keith, you know, they're dogs, they fight all the time, you know what I mean? There's no give up on them.
Yeah, like, and I mean, for Keith especially, like you're talking about the line, like, I mean, I feel it went under the radar how well he did against Galore Bafondo, right? Because everyone's talking about this guy, he's a highlight reel knockout artist. Keith takes the fight in short notice and stands with him for the majority of it and does really well. I know he didn't come away with the win, but do you believe that a lot more people are kind of, they're aware of what he's capable of after that fight?
Yeah, I think Juno and the matchmakers in Bellator were impressed that he took the fight without, and they said, look, there's a spotter coming up. He was jumping on the fight, went over, fought a very good striker, a guy that's finishing fellas on the feet, you know, world level kickboxer, and Keith stood out the top of him. He didn't get his own game plan out. We didn't take him down like we wanted it. I wasn't there, and sometimes I blame myself that you do need to be able to give him a kick in the ass, you know what I mean? But yeah, I think people watch that fight and say, hang on a minute, this guy can stand and throw punches and kicks, he can take a shot too, you know. People haven't seen his jiu-jitsu. He's very good. He fights in the jiu-jitsu scene here, the them events to be on, and he's very good, you know.
Yeah, and just like finally, right? And it was never, this conversation was never really coming from you, but just from fans and stuff. But the last card, they'd say like, SPG, this is all about SPG. Where's the love for Team Ryano? Do you feel as though you were on good terms, Team Rhino's on good terms with Bellator? Do you think it's improved from the first time around, even if it didn't need to improve at all? But how do you feel about that?
Yeah, I think for us, we were never the big fish, so I can understand SPG getting all the glory. They are a big team. They have a lot of good fighters over there. You know, John is well in with the Bellator lads. He has lads in the main event. We don't need a couple of lads in the card. I've never really had any dealings with any of the Bellator staff where I do with Jude all the time. So we probably haven't been that friendly because we just don't know them, you know. Where other shows, we have been friendly because we've been, I suppose, stuck in there. People know when you come to Ireland, it's not just one team. I have a high respect for John and SPG. They've done marvellous things. I must be one of the biggest teams in Europe. But we're here as well, you know. We're on all the shows. Any show that's come here, we've been on them. Not just on them, winning on them, with good fighters, you know. So I do think that Bellator do respect us. Just we haven't had the time to, so I suppose, socialise with them or to sit down and talk to them. And I suppose we're not the big fish in Dublin, you know.
And finally, this is a new partnership you guys have with O'Shea's here, right? And I believe there's going to be a few post-fight drinks after Bellator back here. Maybe even a Neil Seary sighting.
Neil will be here. Yeah, well, what happened was Bill McCann and two of the people that in this bar here work in their place, and they said, you know, I'm going to help the fighters out. So they sponsor a couple of fighters, and they have this place available then. Like, a bit of food on today, we use coming up. So before the fight, be three pre-drinks here, be drinks after the fight. You know, so that's somewhere for us to go. That we can get in.
Thanks so much, Andy. I really appreciate it.
No problem, PC. Thanks a lot.